Hello, my name is Maxime Chambreuil. I'm an architect at Open Source Integrators. Today we're going to discuss DDMRP, Demand Driven Material Requirements Planning. So let's get back to the decoupling point within your organization. So to avoid shortages or overstock, the idea is to set up some buffer within your bill of material and on some purchase items. And the idea is to install breakwall to avoid bullwhip effect propagation. And by setting those buffers, you allow yourself to answer customer demands or to answer procurement orders quicker than just going down the chain and trying to purchase items you should have in stock. So once your buffer or position within the network, you can see here same products before and after buffer positioning. The lead time for the FPD on the left is 52 days because you have to go down the chain of producing 210, 310 and purchasing 410p and 412p, which has a purchase lead time of 45 days. By just putting some buffers within that chain, you reduce your decoupled lead time to 7 days. Because the buffer will allow you to always have 410p and 412p available in stock. So within 7 days, so within the production of 310, 210, and FPD, within 7 days, you can serve your buffer on FPD and serve your customer. So what's the three zones in the buffer and what are they used for? The green zone is the central point of the buffer. It defines how often and with which quantity you want to order a certain item. And we'll see later the net flow is going to move within that green zone. The yellow zone is here to cover your demand while you are expecting some resupply from suppliers or from your manufacturing line. And the red zone is basically the safety embedded into the buffer. So the more variability you have in the supply of a product, the thicker will be the red zone to make sure you never run out. So how do we compute those zones? There is two elements that are taken into account. First is the buffer profile. So a buffer profile has three main characteristics. So the type to determine if the product is manufactured, is purchased, or is distributed. The lead time, it's up to each company, and so you just define if it's a short, medium, or long. And based on this choice, there is a factor that will be applied to calculation. And same thing for variability. So whether it's highly variable or not, so it's low, medium, or high. And same thing, there is a factor that will influence the computation of your zones. And the second item is the average daily usage. So there is different way to compute ADU. You can look at the fixed value, or you can look at 12 weeks in the past or 12 weeks in the future. And you can see on the right how the choices here influence your result in terms of getting closer to the demand. And you can also have a mix of the past and your future. So because the ADU is computed every day, and looking at past or future data, this ADU will change. And because it's used as an input of the buffer zones, your buffer zone sizes will change as well. And so that's how we can have those graphics here, which shows the history of the zones based on the ADU. And so you can see on the top left product being discontinued, or bottom left product being launched, and various other behavior here on the right. Let's now talk about the net flow equations. So the net flow is the quantity you have on hand in your warehouse plus the quantity on order that's supposed to be arriving within your warehouse within the lead time minus the demand, so qualified demand within the lead time as well. So that's why on the schema here on the left you have the on order. So you have 37 plus 35 on order, which gives you 72. We have 65 on hand, which is the on hand position with the dotted line. And on the right, you have the demand. So qualified demand is basically what do you have to ship today. So on day one, you have 10 to ship plus the quantity that goes over the spikes horizon. So you can see on day 8, we have demand for 30 items. That's way over the threshold. So that's why our qualified demand is 10 plus 30, which is 40 items here, which gives us our net flow position at 97. And so because the net flow position is in the yellow zone, the idea is the procurement team should launch a procurement order. How many? So 60 to push the net flow position from the current position to the top of green on day 8. So that will allow us to absorb the spikes we have on day 8. And we have a lead time of 7. So if we order today, the 60 item will be fine to answer the demand on day 8. So some conclusions about DDMRP. As you will see, the buffer self-adapt by design because the ADU is calculated every day and will update the sizes of your zone, of your buffers. You can have buffers for the same products in different warehouse, so they manage distributed chains. If you want to use future data for the calculation of the ADU, you can of course integrate forecast, even if, as we said at the beginning, forecasts are highly inaccurate. You can still use them to predict the demand and base your ADU for this. In terms of operations, it's a pretty easy steps. So the planning team is supposed to review and manages the DDMRP settings, like the buffer profiles, factors for variability, the factors for the lead time, minimum order quantity, those kind of data that influences the buffers. The procurement team is supposed to look at the net flow position, and once the net flow position of a product reaches the yellow zone, creates the procurement for the manufacturing or buying team to start working on procuring that item. And the manufacturer or buyers, they have an easy way to see priorities through this red, yellow, and green colors that's being used not only on buffers, but also on the on-hand level within the buffer.
Well, thank you, Max, for an excellent demo and presentation. I hope our audience was able to see the power behind DDMRP in Odoo. There are 4 more videos on our website, so what are those?
There is one for the planners and SNOP meeting. There is another one for the procurement team and the buyers. And the last one is for the production team.
Yeah, so please visit our website at opensourceintegrators.com and you will be able to search for DDMRP and find those immediately. Thanks for watching.